Yeah, it's a little breezy out here in Florida. This is nuts, man. Devin and I might just try and do some kayak fishing in this, but the problem is, where are we gonna launch? Because right here beyond this bridge, it is absolutely beautiful. There's literally docks that we can hit back there. Fish are jumping, it's so calm. But out here, it's absolute madness. Okay, so we went out to the pier and tried to get some live shrimp. All they had was frozen shrimp, and then also it started pouring on us, so it didn't really work out too well. And needless to say, sunset was fast approaching. We called it and said we're gonna do this the next day, which turned out to be a fantastic idea. So what we did is got up before sunrise, we went out to Annie's Bait and Tackle and got some live shrimp. They seem to be the spot if you want live shrimp. I'm gonna go ahead and get these guys in the water. Okay, so they're in there. We want them to be as lively as possible. And check this out. We literally scoped out this spot yesterday because there's no public ramp into this little canal back here. And so you have to kind of like launch in the surf, and it gets real sketchy because out there it's very windy. You guys saw that at the beginning of the video. I don't need to explain it to you. But anyways, we're going to launch the kayaks, and it's much easier now because the tide is higher today. This drop is literally 2 feet when yesterday it was like 6 feet. It's nuts. We're not used to seeing high and low tides. So we're in a good spot because the kayaks are right here. We're going to drop these things in and get to fishing. So I'm actually going to take out the bona fide today since there's not too much of a breeze back here. So I'm going to be paddling for the first time in a while, but the bona fide is a little bit lighter than that big old autopilot 120 with the motor. So if we're going to be picking this thing up over the ledge later, might just make things a little bit simpler. Devin's going to be on the pedal drive, and this is about all we're taking with us right here, guys. Check that out. So literally we've got a bag full of some gloves, grippers, pliers, line cutters, and some artificial plastics. Devin and I are going to have two rods apiece, one with an artificial on it and one with the live shrimp. And then we have a cast net just in case we get caught up in maybe a spot where we're starting to see bait jump and I can maybe get us some extra live bait. That would be interesting. It would definitely be like some shiners, so that would be cool. We've got a rope. We had bought this because yesterday, like I said, the drop right here was 6 feet. So whenever we left this place, we were gonna like rope up the front ends of the kayaks and just yank them up and over this. But now hopefully it'll be much easier. We're about to get these things in the water. All right, we've got it all just about rigged up. Lock the truck. Three. Perfect. All right. Devin says she sees a ton of bait fish. Let's try and get some. A ton. Okay.
That was not good.
How do you do this? Reel the cord up into your, oh, that's what I didn't do. Got him. There we go. Success. Give me the bait bucket. I'm going to take this thing out.
What are you targeting?
Moving everything.
Y'all have a good one. There's my two combos, y'all. We got one like 7 foot medium heavy with a Stratic CI4. It has got like 8 pound braid with a 10 or 12 pound fluorocarbon leader. And then we got this big rig right here. This is a Fenwick. I don't even know the size. It's probably like a 7.6. Devin's dad just picked it up while he was out here along with a pin, 4,000 spool sized clash. And then on that, we've got like 50 pound braid and a 20 pound leader with the swim bait. So. Yeah, I'm going straight for the live shrimp. Anything and everything will hit it out here. And with this light gear, the fights could get a little crazy if I hook up into anything decent sized. So it's gonna be fun. There you go. All right, there we go. There's my first fish in the morning. This is this little guy. I think I got something on. He might have came off actually. No, he's there. I got something small. This must be the bluegill of the sea. I don't know if I've caught one of these yet though. This is pretty sick actually. He's got like orange lines and a black dot on him.
I feel like maybe this is just a juvenile of something larger that I've already caught. All right, I need the pliers. There we go. We are on the hunt for something much bigger, of course. But sometimes you gotta go through a couple of the young bucks to get to the giants. And I'll tell you what, anything and everything will hit the live shrimp out here. So there's no telling when you might just get a big one out of nowhere. I need to run over and see Devin for some more live shrimp though. The target species we're going for here is, like, for me, the snook, redfish. Might get some trout, but I'd rather catch snook or redfish. I'd love a shark, but I think it's easiest to get those on cut bait. So, like, maybe if I were to have chopped up that fish that I caught just a moment ago to try and get a shark, there's potential for that. I would have definitely thrown that on the bigger rig, of course, not this lighter setup. But that would be pretty crazy. I'm getting hits right now. This is a lot different than fishing the freshwater ponds out in Texas like we normally do. Fish are on a whole nother level out here. They'll take your shrimp too. Devin and I went with 5 dozen this morning, which might have been overkill, but when you find a good bite, these fish are just constantly taking your shrimp off the hook, and you could go through a dozen so fast, especially between like two people. So yes, if the bite's not too hot, you paid for a little extra that you can give back to the ocean or some other anglers that you see on the bank and on the piers. So we went through 4 dozen the other day fairly quickly. Went through 2 or 3 dozen off the pier one night in just a couple hours, and that was kind of like with a slow bite. So if you're grabbing live bait and you're going to do something like go out on the kayaks and you're just really anticipating to use the live bait the majority of the time, if the bite's hot, you're going to need a little extra. And I realize the inconvenience. You got to, like, when there's a little breeze, there's just no way. I've been using the one on the trolling motor or the pedal drive, and you can just steer, mess around with your feet, you can keep your hands free. Not on this guy. The kayak itself is sick, but just the paddling versus the pedaling or the trolling motor is like, holy cow. Here's a bunch of those bait. So if they start getting blown up on, I might be in a good spot right here. I'm kind of just below them. So, oh, you know what? I'm actually going to cast behind me towards those mangroves. Yeah, there's some stuff maybe roaming through. There we go, right on the edge. The snook like to hang with the cover, so that's actually probably the best spot if I was just gonna be trying to get the snook here. And I'm probably gonna drift. Okay, I got some room. I'm drifting into what could be people's docks, but I got a little bit of room here. What's gonna bite? Doesn't seem like there's as much action back here. As many fish jumping. Did you really? Okay. I just got one little deal. I don't even know what it was. Working our ways back a little bit. This is pretty sick, man. Never fished anything like this before. Mangroves to the left and the right. It's narrowing down. Haven't seen as many fish jump, but this other couple that's kayaking back here said they saw. They said the big reds are back here waiting for us, so. Yeah, I think we should go back out to that open area. We're headed back out to the main water. Devin is towing me with the pedal drive, though. Making life easy. All right, y'all, Devin and I switched things up on you out here. She's gonna throw the shrimp for a minute, and I am gonna try to not lose my hook. I'm gonna try and throw the shiner. So, let's get one of these guys, bait him up. Oh, not the most lively. There's a good one. All right, let's toss this guy out. This sucks compared to using the trolling motor. You literally can't do You can't stay in a spot. You can't, like, stay on the fish. No, I'm gonna throw another shiner, but I'm gonna go out there by, like, where the bridge is and try and throw one and see if they're active over there. I wanna go check out how windy it is where it opens up to the sea. Yeah, it's starting to get a little breezy. Yep, so as you can see, this is where it gets a little choppy. I wonder if I should, like, make a cast right here. This doesn't look half bad. Might be something active hanging out by the bridge. Hey, let's see what we got. Probably got another 15 minutes to half an hour to fish. This is just Devin and I's last little sin before we gotta check out of our Airbnb and head back to Texas. And there we go. I think this is actually what we want. Oh my, we got something that's taking a little drag. First cast over here. That is quite interesting. I wonder what we have on this hook. Remember, this is my light setup, so it could be something small, but to take out the line like that on the initial run is pretty sick. Oh, you know what? It looks like a little Jack Crevalle. It's looking like it's got some yellow fins. This might be something I need to actually break out the gloves for. Oh yeah, we got us a Jack, it looks like. Sick. All right, this is the deal right here. This is the juice. This is a, like, 12-pound line. We should be okay. Get in the boat. Yeah, and my reel. That should get in the boat too. All right, guys. There you go. A nice little jack. You hear him grunting? So funny, man. Let's get this guy back in the water. He's got some semi-sharp teeth right there. He'll get you. Sick. Nice little fish to start things off today. I would say start things off because that first one was hardly worth catching. But all right, get him back in the water. See if I can't make that happen another time or two by the bridge. Boom. Love these grippers right here. This is also a scale, but there's no point in weighing him. So anyways, a pair of grippers is kind of like a must on the ocean. A little bit different than just lipping a largemouth bass in the ponds I'm used to, so. Kayaks are up on the trailer, y'all, but we are resuming by foot since I found that bite right here under the bridge. We're gonna see if we can get a couple more fish before we call it quits. Probably an easy target out here because I doubt the shiner cruised this far. Oh, I smacked him on the bridge. He's probably not good anymore.
All right, y'all, that does it for this one. Devin and I got the kayaks off the water. Crazy windy conditions. First time really using a cast net on our channel, so that was pretty fun. I think third time's the charm with my throwing skills. But guys, check out the Caddo Lake video. It was our kind of like, this was the last video in Florida, right? But we also stopped on the Louisiana-Texas border and hit Caddo Lake on the way back. If you haven't seen that one, guys, it's completely off the chain. We want to take the boat over there, but I told you guys we'll only do it if we get to 1,000 likes on the video. It's currently at like 700 plus. Thank you guys so much for all the support. If we can get it to 1,000, we're gonna do a big trip back over there. And also we've got a lot more content coming down the pipeline very soon. So be on the lookout, subscribe, notifications. You know the deal if you ain't already. Thank you guys so much for watching till the end, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace.